I am Shubham Nahar and we are from VIVO, Salem.
And we welcome you to the induction presentation for the batch 2019 and 21.
Before starting, I am having one question. So, most of us are sports over here. So, can anyone name a company which is sponsoring IPL?
VIVO.
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 So, we have a video for you guys.
World's first 32 megapixel pop-up selfie camera, VIVO V15 Pro.
Come to our topic of the presentation, that is the marketing strategies of VIVO Mobiles.
Now we will take you through the introduction.
So coming to the introduction, VIVO was founded by Sam Wing and it was founded in the year 2019. And the parent company was BBK Electronics. Mind it, it's not BBK Wines, it's BBK Electronics. And the headquarters was at Dangong, China. And the major servicing area are like South Asia, Southeast Asia, Russia, China and India. And VIVO entered the Indian market in the year 2014.
So, the vision of the company is to become happier, long-lasting as a global corporation. And the objective why we choose this topic is, this company believes in innovation as phone, which is an important thing of our day-to-day life. Each and everyone wants a phone or a mobile phone to be like something which is recent. So this company, they just keep on innovating, and this company believes in innovation, and so do we.
So coming to the revenue of the VIVO India, as you can see from the chart that the revenues are increasing exponentially year by year. So as you can see in the financial year 2016 and 17, it was just a name, like any other mobile companies. And with a whooping increase of 500% in their revenue, in the year 2017 and 18, they marked themselves as a brand. And then in the financial year 2018 and 19, they got an increase of like 80% in the revenue over the 500%. And they become a consumer based, a huge consumer based company with a good number of shares in their online and the offline market, and they had a revenue of ₹11,154, that is 11,154 crore rupees.
So now I will take you through market share. As we can see, the market share of VIVO in 2018 quarter one is 6%, whereas in the next year, that is in 2019, it rises to 12%. Compared to like other things which are the tough competitors, that is Samsung and Xiaomi.
So as shown said that there was an increase of around 100% of the share market in from the fiscal year of 2018 quarter one and to the fiscal year of 2019 quarter one. And we can say that this increase is just because of the marketing strategies that VIVO is adopting. So coming to the 4P analysis of marketing strategies, the first P is product. And VIVO mainly depends on the innovation. And being a valuable customer, I can say that VIVO depends to deliver innovation. And VIVO has brought three of the most important innovations in the mobile industries. Following the first is that they have brought the slim phone with the model VIVO X Max 5. That they have brought the inbuilt display sensors with the model VIVO X21 in the year 2018, and they have got the first open selfie camera in the same year with VIVO Next.
The second P is price. So, and first point is competitive pricing strategy. Competitive pricing strategy doesn't mean that they are manufacturing low cost phone or high cost phone. They have both premium sector. They are both in the premium sector as well as in the mass sector, but the thing they are giving based on the value. is quite worth it, because of which we have seen that the growth rate is also quite good. And the second point is retailer's margin. In most of the business, you take any company, Xiaomi and Samsung. So the manufacturers here, they offer to retailers for selling their product just a profit margin of 5 to 6%. Whereas this company is offering profit margin of 12 to 15%, which is one of the most important factor in this growth and development of their business. Then comes present in the right band, which means that they are in every sector. They are in the range of 10 to 15 also, 15 to 25 also, and above 35, 40 also. And the next comes is place. So this company or any company here in India, as per the survey, so most of their revenue comes at 60% from the offline business. So the most important factor here is place. So place plays an important role. There are near to 60,000 outlets that this company is having. Those are like electronic shops or most of the company outlets also. And the products are available in quantity and also on the time, because of which these customers are having direct interface with the device, and they are enjoying that customer experience, because of which also product is increasing.
So coming to the last bit, that is promotion, you can say that the company has embraced a 360 degree marketing strategy, that they have done advertisement in all the possible sectors. Like they have done the commercial television, they have done endorsement with the brands and with the big celebrities like Amir Khan and Arjun Singh, and they have done all the possible things they can do on their on-ground activities to retain their offline sales also.
So now, as this company has already set up a good customer base, so they are now moving to online sector. As they are offering 12 to 15% of margin, which is also huge margin, so they are cutting on that and using that money in their innovation. They are setting up new laboratories, hiring new engineers for their research and development sector. And now they are going launching a Z series, which is exclusively just for online. They have also invested in the Make in India. That is 4,000 crore, which will be one of their promotion motive, that they will be generating near to 5,000 jobs. Along with that, they have already invested 800 crores in this sector, and they are trendsetter. As my friend already explained, that they are the one who bought a pop-up camera, slimmest phone, and also hi-fi that facility. So yes, they are the trendsetters.
So coming to the segmentation section, we have brought the demographic segmentation, and the company has categorized the age group of the people. Like they have brought the different mobiles for the different age group. Like they have came with the 18 to 30 year age group, then 22 to 30 year age group, then 26 to 25 year age group, and 25 to 40 year age group. In that, they have mobile phones for all the sectors, for all the age groups of the population.
So they are in near to 400 cities, as well as they are both in offline and online marketing also. And just because of their good channeling and good interaction with their retailers, they are having good business. So, and they are also in the premium sector, standard sector, and now they are setting up their base in the mass sector also.
So coming to the conclusion, VIVO has one of the most unique marketing strategies, that they entered the market with the offline market, and they were providing a good number of shares margin to the retailers.
And as we have seen, there is exponential growth in the financial capital that this company has acquired.
And they have acquired good marketers within a short span of time, that is within 4 years time, they have acquired a good market risk in the Indian mobile market.
Thank you.